What's up, guys? Today I'm in the 2017 Bentley Bentayga. We're gonna go through all the ins and outs of it, tell you what I like and don't like, and we're just gonna check out the interior, exterior, you know, any quirks it might have or what makes it special. Being a Bentley, there should be a lot that makes it special, so let's go find out. All right, here she is, 2017 Bentley Bentayga. Finished in this amazing orange flame metallic paintwork, which here in the South Florida sun, it looks absolutely incredible. Complemented by the black 22-inch wheels. Nice rotational design. And plenty of chrome bright work, which is what Bentley is famous for. Lots and lots of chrome. I feel like if you're gonna own one of these cars, it has to be in a crazy color like this. And now that the sun is really out, you can see just how gorgeous this paint is. Absolutely flawless. Full panoramic roof. One thing I always love about Bentleys is that their headlights are like works of art. There's so many intricate little details that you can find in these headlights, not just the Bentley logo or name, but everything. All the little mirrors and reflectors, the way everything is etched out, that knurled look to the, you know, outside little ring here. You can't forget that big grille too. All the little parking sensors, front camera. This vehicle is equipped with the adaptive cruise control and lane keep assist. See a little camera up there. And as nice as these headlights look when they're off, they look even cooler when they're on. So let's jump inside real quick. I'm gonna throw on the headlights as well as the hazard lights. With all these cars, you usually have to start it. Let's start it up real quick. Just the start button. Nice little burble from the exhaust. All right, so turn them on. Put the hazard lights on. Soft closed doors, of course. All right, now let's see how they look. So as you can see, the inner lamp is one giant self-contained LED unit, the high beam and the low beam. And then the outer fixtures are just the turn signal. Actually, what's kind of cool is this body color little oval here. At night, when you're using the windshield wipers, the headlight washers will actually extend from here. So I guess it'll be just within range of, you know, kind of cooling it here so it all comes off. All right, let's go to the back and see how the taillights look. Of course, you have LED indicators mounted in the mirrors, nice and bright. The taillights are also full LED units. We have the Bentley B incorporated into the design. Very bright. We got the reverse B over here. A very clean design. It's probably one of the more good-looking SUVs on the market. Although it's not cheap, so definitely only available to a small percentage of people. But nonetheless, it is a looker. There's actually a few places on the Bentayga and also other Bentleys where you can see the Bentley B. So here on the fender vents, it's a little B. We got the Union Jack down here. All right, let's check out the back seat of this thing. No surprise, the quality and craftsmanship of the interior is second to none when it comes to Bentley. Whether it's the diamond stitching, the double stitching in the doors that matches the body color, or the metal speaker grills for the name audio system, which we'll listen to later. Sounds very good. Soft closed doors. And sitting behind myself, I actually have plenty of room back here. Very nicely appointed. You have the Bentley logos and the matching fire orange. And of course, you have power window shades, as well as on the passenger side. And they are one touch, so one touch of a button. And for the passenger side, as well as a full panorama roof. Rear AC, two zone. And you actually have this little tablet, like with other Bentleys. And you can control pretty much everything. See your vehicle data, outside temperature, and get your seat controls, for heated seats. This one doesn't have the option for cooled seats, but you got the volume controls here, entertainment. You can connect the device, change your source for satellite radio.
Mashup channels, workout channels,
All right. Let's see how that name audio system sounds. Go volume. And you got dual cup holders here, which even has a nice diamond stitching inside for your drinks, so they're nice and comfortable. All right, let's go check out the front. All right, so up front in the Bentayga, it is, yes, just as nice as the back, with no shortage of leather, color match double stitching, aluminum, wood, just metal everywhere, leather. The entire headliner of this truck is a full leather in the grab handles. Of course, wouldn't expect anything else. And you got leather wrapped visors, which yes, the door for the mirror is of course leather. Got a nice little LED light up there. Nice frameless rear view mirror here. All your ambient lighting, everything is LED, touch sensitive. Your garage door opener. Nice semi-digital gauge cluster with, of course, analog gauges. And here a little turbo flutter from that W12. This is actually not the twin turbo 4-liter V8 or the base model engine. It's the upgraded twin turbo W12. You can actually see the full color heads-up display. Right now it's only displaying the speed, but has all sorts of features. Looks like this truck has night vision. I'm not sure how to actually activate that. Regular AC controls, shifter, all the controls for off-road, hill descent assist, traction control, can raise and lower the adaptive air suspension. And now we get to one of my bigger gripes with the entire Bentley range. For some reason, they've insisted on using this outdated infotainment screen for years. It's not very responsive. It's got these horrible looking volume knobs, selector knobs here. I mean, hopefully they fix it with the next generation of Bentayga and Mulsanne and, you know, Continental GT, Flying Spur. But honestly, that's the only thing I have to complain about with this truck. It's really not much, because everything else is just a delight. What I really love is the organ poles for the AC. Turn them off, turn them on. Of course, you have the analog clock there. like I said, just the, you know, the quality is really unmatched.
The only thing I could really compare it to is, you know, Rolls-Royce, even Mercedes, Maybach, cars like that, basically in the same class. This is an interesting looking cover for the, looks like it's for the cup holders, but there's like a leather cover on it. It's interesting. Oh, it looks like this whole thing is just one cover for the cup holders. It's nice and leather in there. That is interesting. Just locks in there and it closes. Just for some storage. Got a little cubby hole over here. Got the dual, and yeah, that same diamond stitching and everything. All little cubby holes. Got a 12 volt power outlet. Some USB ports, auxiliary port.
And you got your blind spot monitors there, the sensors, which is the same throughout the whole VW group.
Bentley, Audi, Lamborghini, Porsche.
Well, Porsche is a little different. Theirs is up on the A-pillar. Kind of like a little sensor here. It lights up red, but yeah. I'm not really sure how I feel about that. I really prefer what actually Mercedes, BMW now, and Rolls-Royce is doing, which is, you know, the little triangle out on the mirror.
Nice full leather wrapped steering wheel with the contrast stitching and body color. And that orange flame. Little metal pieces here. Got metal paddle shifters. Nice bright work. Definitely a nice place to be. No doubt about that.
That should do it for this review of the 2017 Bentley Bentayga. All right, guys, see you next time.